Rogers Arena in Vancouver in a Saturday night showdown between Pacific Division rivals Calgary and the Canucks. And now Matthew Tkachuk plays the puck to the middle, and it's poked forward. Michael Backlund, here comes Markstrom, and diving was Gudbranson. Markstrom's down way out of the net. Gudbranson playing goal for the moment as Markstrom scrambles back to the goal crease, and the puck comes to the blue line where the Canucks are able to move it out of harm's way.
He didn't hesitate. He went right at it, and you're coming the other way full speed. That was almost a head-on collision.
Those big goalies are hard to find holes.
Here's Troy Stetcher with a long shot. Loose puck, right pad, saved by Smith off Daniel Sedin. He needed every inch of his height to make that save. Hamilton ahead for Lazar, who stumbled. Dorsett flips one through. Here's Granlund centering. Sutter couldn't get it by Smith, who sprawled and got the glove down.
He has been really good so far in this one. Only five shots, but he's had some real difficult saves to make.
And Giordano just reached in, knocked the puck off his stick. Gets it in the corner. And the Flames, Brower's going to move it out. Here's a three-on-one shorthanded for Calgary. Hamilton in. Giordano shoots. Scores! Mark Giordano shorthanded. His 100th career NHL goal.
Nowadays, everyone gets down on the ground to try to block the lanes. Giordano breaks that play up, and then he's not done yet. He gets up with the play. He stays with the play. And I wasn't sure giving the puck to Hamilton was a good idea because he was kind of standing still. But Brower gives it to him. He finds Giordano late, and the captain gets its 100th career goal.
2.5 minutes to go in the first. Calgary leading 1-0 as Delzato rushes the puck ahead. Bernistrov in on the left wing. Gets around Dougie Hamilton, who broke his stick. Puck is center. Quick shot. Stop. And it's in, says Ian Walsh, the referee. Derek Dorsett had the chance in front. Puck's in the goal, and the game is tied at one.
I actually thought Bennett was getting another penalty. He takes down Dorsett right here going by. Trips him right there, and the referee, I thought he was going to call it. I go, you got to be kidding me, not another one. Now follow Dorsett. He's going to come right into the play and get this shot. It's eventually going to find its way back into the net. An unfortunate break for Smith, who's been pretty sharp for Calgary. And for the Vancouver Canucks, blank on the power play. And then you get a break and you get a goal and you're right back in it.
Frolik turning, putting one off the right pad of Markstrom. Puck loose at the side. Gaudreau's lost his stick, but he continues to fight for the puck. It comes in front. Hamonic shoots. He scores! Travis Hamonic came in off the blue line. Beat Markstrom, and the Flames lead 2-1.
Hard work down low by the Calgary Flames. Good puck possession by Frolik. He gets it to the net. There's Gaudreau losing his stick, but he kind of shields the puck. Doesn't put his hand on it this time, though, and that allows some of the other Flames to support him and get to the puck. And once they did, it spit itself out to the top of the slot, and then it was Hamonic who came in and got it. See, everyone's trying to look for it, and at the end of the day, there's Monahan who digs it out with Frolik. And all the blue sweaters that you see there, none of them are paying attention to the one guy who put it into the back of the net, and that was Hamonic. In the first 3 or 4 minutes, we must have had 5 quality scoring chances. In the second period, it has just tightened up. The neutral zone is so tough to get through right now.
There's a centering pass knocked away by Markstrom. He can't reach the loose puck. Backhander, he got it with the left pad, and he's able to cover. Curtis Lazar got his stick on that one. And with Markstrom down, he couldn't get it up in the air and into the net.
Was a scorer in junior, and you think if he got just a couple, even ones bouncing it off him, who cares? You think he would get some confidence in himself, but it's been frustrating around the net for him. And for the Calgary Flames, finally, as Bennett crashes over the top of Markstrom, they got some rhythm coming through the neutral zone.
Sean Monahan with a face-off win. Here's a long shot off the post. No, it's in. Pardon me. Markstrom never saw it. The shot from Dougie Hamilton in and out, but the important part is it was in first, and Calgary leads 3-1.
Nice turn draw. It gets back to the point. Monahan backs himself out of the face-off circle. And normally you want to see center on center, so whoever took that draw with him should be the guy that's moving out with him.
When the puck gets stalemated at the blue line, there's not much room to get any momentum.
Here's Gaudreau, and it banked in off Delzato. Trying to center the puck, Johnny Gaudreau winds up scoring a goal, a power play tally, and the Flames lead 4-1.
Brody does the right thing. Take it back, get some of those forwards in motion, create a little more rhythm, and then take the attack at the blue line, and that's exactly what they do. And Gaudreau does a nice job of cutting across with some speed. Jágr back to Gaudreau, and as he goes to throw this to the net, I believe it goes off the skate of Michael Delzato. We'll have a good look at it here. Yeah, the back foot, and that fools Markstrom coming across.
Second straight game that's happened to Michael Delzato, as Josh Morrissey put one in off his skate in the Winnipeg game. So hard luck. Here's a lead pass. Brock Besser's in. He shoots. He scores. Seconds after the Gaudreau goal, Besser gets the Canucks back to within two.
Four goals in five exhibition games, and when you look at him, he's a first guy on puck player. He's hard on the puck, he dogs the puck. But the other thing on his resume, he has got a great release wrist shot, and what a beauty goal for Besser.
Stetcher one hands the puck up the boards. Tkachuk holds it in. Here's Dougie Hamilton. Rolling puck, lets it go, and it's in! Right through Markstrom. Hamilton with the shot, and the Flames go back up by three.
And they finally got some good energy, and they're coming. And then this is what happens, a rolling puck, and it's bouncing around the Vancouver end. You think, okay, we're gonna get this puck, we're gonna get it up the wall, but they don't. And it ends up being a D-to-D pass. And this puck, which is kind of flipping end over end, and there you see it wobbling, and those pucks sometimes are very difficult, and the puck wobbling like it was found a way to fall and filter through.
Here's a long shot off the post as Erika Branson put one towards the net. Dan Hutton, shot from the line, glove saved by Smith, who hangs on to that one with 8:16 to go in the third.
And again, it's a quick draw back to the point, D to D, and then just a fluttering shot coming in, but it's coming through depth screening. And Smith, as big a player, as goalie that he is, he's down awful early, and he's not sure where it is, and he just heard the clank of the post.
Shot on goal. Flames in good shape for a bounce back after losing 6-0 last night at home to Ottawa. Calgary doing it on the strength of special teams in this one tonight.
Well, they have. And when they won those two games in California, it was a real big emotional lift for them. And they came home. And when they got home, all that emotion that they'd built up on that trip to California, they kind of let down when they got home. And you see that very often after. I mean, you go into California and beat the Anaheim Ducks and the LA Kings, you're feeling pretty good about yourself.
TJ Brody digs the puck free, battles for it behind the net. Don't forget, after this game concludes, Bobby Ryan and Ryan Nugent-Hopkins will be with Scott Oak on After Hours after the Ottawa-Edmonton game at Rogers Place. As this one comes to an end, Calgary behind the goaltending of Mike Smith, strong penalty killing. 100th career goal for that man, Mark Giordano. And team effort through and through after their loss to Ottawa last night. Calgary bounces back, beats Vancouver, and hands the Canucks their third straight loss.